there's still no change in Cecil's condition. So I've taken a room at the hospital so I can be near him. I'm on my way there now. So you can reach me there if you hear anything.
Well, if I hear anything, I'm sure that it's going to be good news. And look, Alexis, tell Cecil that I'm sorry that he's ill, but I wish him well. And I'm sorry for you about your wedding being postponed. I know that's upsetting you, along with what's happened here.
Oh, Blake, the only thing that's upsetting me now is the baby. Do you know that Cecil insists on marrying me as soon as possible, even if it's from his hospital bed? Fallon. Oh, darling, you look so pale. Why don't you...
My mother and my father have deceived me. Why didn't you ever tell me about the other child? It was my own flesh and blood.
You had a right to know. Yes, Fallon, you did. I wanted to tell you, but you were so young and I had to leave. It was your father's decision not to tell you.
Fallon, I made that decision for good reasons. For you and Stephen.
Meaning what?
Meaning I didn't want you to grow up fearful about your own safety. You can understand that, can't you?
Well, maybe if you had told me, I could have protected my own son.